even though I named it the Gulf Blue Plague and the Gulf Blue Flu, which Gulf Blue Flu was repeated by a lot of people on non-mainstream radio and on the internet. But now, back not too long ago, September 6th, had an article that was featured in NationalExaminer.com, which is just Examiner.com. It was written by Deborah Dupre, and her headline was Censored Gulf News, Mutating Viruses, Mandatory Vaccines Loom. Now, I'll just mention some of what she has in here because there's no need to read the whole thing. She said, Gulf Blue Plague, gee, she used my words, is evolving biologically into a petrochemical, military, industrial complex, PMIC she calls it, chemically induced breeding ground for mutating viruses, making New World Order's mandatory vaccines easier to justify on an unwitting public. Vaccines are considered by many scientists and medical professionals as weapons of mass destruction. And she has some links to back up her statements. Mandatory flu vaccines are being promoted by, quote, the organized demons that created this year's risk of a super flu, end quote, according to Dr. Len Horowitz. Again, I'm not going to read all of this, just the first part. For 4 months, the PMIC, which again, I had never heard that term, so let me say it again what PMIC is. Maybe she came up with that. I don't know. Petrochemical Military Industrial Complex. I've always heard Military Industrial Complex. Never heard the petrochemical part before, so she's probably come up with something as new as us coming up with Gulf Blue Plague. but she says, for 4 months, the PMIC's continued poisoning, in parentheses, gassing, Gulf region residents with an unprecedented amount of Corexit's chemical compound 2-butyloxyethanol. I used to know how to pronounce that. poisonous to human blood, kidneys, liver, and central nervous system. Bingo, remember I just said the kidneys, the liver, mm-hmm. that you were talking mm-hmm. about, and hemorrhagic diseases off of the list from the health department? Okay. Eventually, Corexit also ruptures red blood cells, causing internal bleeding. The PMIC is ensuring that millions of residents are poisoned, fulfilling Agenda 21 depopulation. I'm not making any comments on any of that, not today. Corexit spraying continues today, blown further inland by tropical storm and hurricane winds. Well, we haven't had any hurricane winds, so I'd like to correct her on that. And we only had one poofed out tropical storm that wasn't even considered anything other than a bad depression. The top speed of it was 40 miles an hour towards the south end of the Gulf, and then it fizzled out. So, no, we haven't had hurricane winds, and we haven't really had any true tropical storms in the Gulf.
Mm-hmm. So there's a little hyperbole going there.
Yeah, well, I'm correcting her technically on that, and we're not going to either. All the storms are going to be continue to be steered to the east and the west, and we've got the article up there to show how they're doing that. There is a weather mm-hmm. war going. Okay, I'm quoting her just two more paragraphs. One of the two men who sounded the alarm about the looming high death toll is now dead, Matt Simmons. He's the one who supposedly in his hot tub in Maine drowned. And they came back and said that he had a heart attack. You know, when people are suicided, isn't it amazing that, you know, they have an odd drowning in their hat tub, hot tub and things like that. Hat tub. Okay, I'll continue reading. And Matt Simmons, by the way, did blow the whistle that, no, it wasn't one well that was blown. It was 2 and 7 miles away. It's leaking, which I put together later on and realized he was talking about Biloxi Dome, which is leaking. And the government even showed that 7 places along Biloxi Dome, Salt Dome, that it was leaking. he was a whistleblower who brought all that up and was on CNBC and MSNBC and everything else. And all of a sudden, he got suicided, so I wonder why. Whistleblower Hugh Kaufner is the other individual who warned about millions of people anticipated to perish due to the genocidal acts against Americans in the Deep South and Florida. I mean, she's not mincing any words here, that's for sure. And where she said whistleblower Hugh Kaufner, she has a link also to an article dealing with what he said. So you might want to check this out on examiner.com. And the last paragraph I'll read, now it's reported, and she quotes our article, "The Gulf of Mexico is a biological time bomb that is undoubtedly evolving into a chemically induced breeding ground for mutating viruses. All the aspects exist in the Gulf right now and have been established for over 3 months. Their ongoing manipulated evolution into a viral plague or viral epidemic is evident, yet has been ignored." And she was quoting me in our article, "The Blue Plague, Gulf Blue Plague is Evolving, Part 2, Corrects It Plus Bacteria Equals Mutated Viruses." And we had that posted on worldvisionportal.org, and she's quoting me. That was our August 29th article. It's right there. Go do a search on World Vision Portal. You know, Liz, all we can do is just try to get people to at least, you know, one person out of the entire radio show listens while at least somebody is forewarned. And now, like I said, it's coming close to home. It's as far as I'm concerned, affected me now the second time. I had minor symptoms, more of the cough and everything, when I was out on our boat, on a sailboat. When was that? Back in
July.
July, yeah. And I had some different kind of symptoms. I had the headache starting, but it reminded me, quite honestly, I thought that we had gotten into a red tide area in the Gulf, which happens a lot, and that's, you know, that's plankton or whatever, where they the water turns red with them, and the fish die, and your eyes burn and everything else. So that's what I thought initially had happened back in July with me. After that, I realized, no, that wasn't red tide, because there was no report of red tide anywhere. I checked it out, not in that area. And then,
I remember you guys were detoxifying like crazy after that.
Oh, yeah, yeah. I was taking clay, everything else, of which now that's something I've forgotten. You were supposed to remind me. That's why I have you on today, Liz. The bottom line of all this right now with any of the effects, especially the headaches and the fatigue and bones hurting and everything else, which are flu-mimicking symptoms, okay, they're not the flu. If you're living anywhere within 200 miles of the Gulf Coast of Florida, I'll guarantee you it's not the typical flu. It is the Gulf Blue Flu, which is the initial stage of Gulf Blue Plague being caused by an even more complicated bacterial mess, more viral. But the bottom line of how to help yourself, the reason that I'm even doing the show today, I know Liz was worried about me this morning. Believe me, I was worried about me, because that intense a headache and that kind of feeling and my ears ringing and everything, I felt like something blasted me. And, you know, it really knocks you off your feet. And if this is what's happened to you, I'm going to tell you exactly what you have to do to get yourself where you can talk on a radio program a few hours later. And I'm not pushing the product. I don't sell this product. I just happen to know about it. After now, I'm going to start selling it at cost if I have to, just to get it out there. And I'm going to start giving it away if somebody can't afford it, I guess, because I'm not going to let people suffer with these symptoms and eventually die from them. And what it is called cell food. CELLFOOD. And you can go on the internet, do a search for cell food. There's a few distributors out there. There's one company that makes it based in California. Their name starts with now Luminesa or something like that. You'll see that on the internet. You can buy direct from them, or you can buy from any of the distributors that will come up on the search. Most of the local health food stores around the country have cell food. If they don't, tell them to get it. I know that that's where we got it the first time in Sarasota from Richard's Foods. So, you know, anybody in Sarasota, you want cell food, go there. Liz, I'm totally different now than what I was hours ago, huh?
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And that's the cell food. Now, something, see, I'm starting to get there. We got 5 minutes. I can cover this. This morning when I went out, I told you I went out to go feed the horses, and I noticed something that I've never seen before. Again, I don't count that as a coincidence. There's just been too many coincidences today. So I have 9 horses. 5 of them this morning. Two of them are off in a separate paddock. There's actually 7 of them are in the same area at night. They stay out in that pasture. Well, every once in a while when I go out at right before sunup to go bring them in to give them their oats with all the natural minerals and calcium and other things, one might be lying down. This morning, 5 of them were. And in the long run, what I did was I gave them cell food just like I did myself today, and I was able to have all the horses where they're not lethargic like they were this morning. Okay, if it's affecting horses and it affects me, it's real. That's all I can tell you. It's genuine. It's real. And
Michael, you were saying that when you went out this morning, the birds weren't even singing.
Yeah,
we
got 1 minute.
How strange is
that? We got 1 minute here, Liz. We're going to continue this tomorrow because I really need to discuss this in detail. No, the birds weren't singing. I throw seed out by the barn in the back porch every morning, wild bird seed. The squirrels weren't coming up. The birds weren't singing. And we got a family of woodpeckers. They're there every morning. They didn't show up this morning. It was just like everybody went into no-show mode and was tired. So we're out of time, Liz, but, yeah, we're going to detail more of this tomorrow. I covered some details. I'm going to do a little bit more research. I'm going to talk to more people, and I'm going to let everybody know tomorrow how many people that I've spoken with and what the symptoms are and where they live. Join us tomorrow, 2 o'clock Eastern U.S. It's always a pleasure. Remember, be who you were created to be.